Hello students, I hope you are clear with how the transfer of heat takes place from the hotter object to colder object. Okay, but students, have you ever thought that do all the materials which are present, they conduct heat or they conduct hotness? Do all the objects get heated easily? So we can check this through our activity. Okay, so see here, I have this opener. So I have this metallic opener. Even though this is wood, this is of metal. So I have this metallic opener. Then I have your plastic pen near me, and this is, I have wooden pencil, and here I have steel spoon. Okay, so if you see, I have all those objects of different materials. These are different objects of different materials, isn't it? So if you see, this is metal, this is plastic, this is wood, and this is steel. So if we dip this in a hot water, here I have hot water. It's not so hot and not so cool and not even warm. Okay, it's more than warm and less than hot. Okay, so if you see, I will dip all of those in this. Okay, so I have already performed this activity and concluded the observation. You also can do this activity at your home, and you yourself can witness and clarify how the heat transfers and which object gets heated faster. Okay, so through this activity, what did I find? That is, if you see here, this is a steel spoon, this is a plastic, and this is a wood. So all those three objects, from here the heat is transferred from the side which I have dipped, and the heat transfers, and if I touch to the other side, then I don't feel it much hot compared to metal. I will feel the hotness more in the metal compared to those three objects. Why is this so? Because that is all because of what? If you see, then those objects are poor conductors of heat, because they do not allow the hotness to emerge into them easily or pass into them easily compared to the metals. So metals like aluminium or metals like copper or cobalt, all those metals, they are the good conductors, and they are hence called as what? Conductor of heat. Or they are called as what? Conductors. Means the heat which is passed through the objects easily, those objects are called as what? Conductors. And the objects like plastic, wood, or steel, if you see, then those objects are called as what? Insulators. Because the heat is not passed faster compared to the metals, and or they are the poor conductors. They are called as insulators, or they are called as what? Poor conductors. So when you take a metallic pan, and if the handle of that metallic pan is either plastic or even if it is of metal, then while removing it, do you get hurt? Without using a cloth, if you touch the handle of the pan, hot pan, what happens? You will definitely get hurt, because the pan will be very hot, and that heat is passed from the bottom of the pan to the handle, which is either of plastic or of metal. So if it is of metal, you will find it more hotter compared to the plastic, because if it is a plastic and it has generated the heat, then you are not able to touch it. But if it is of metal, for some instant you are able to touch it, because as soon as the heat is passed to the handle of the metal, at the same time it is also transferring heat to its surrounding faster compared to the plastic. So that is why you get hurt when you touch the handle of a hot pan. Similar is in the cases of other objects. Like if you see metal, then metal gets heated early, and that is why it is called as what? Conductor. And if you see the other objects, that is wood, which is pencil of wood, and this is of spoon, which is of steel, and this is pen, which is of plastic. So all those materials are poor conductors, or they are called as what, insulators, because the heat is not passed as faster as the metals. So you can also perform this activity at your home by collecting some objects of different materials. It's not necessary that you have to collect such kind of objects, those objects only. You can find out some metals, you can find out some other materials, you can take some other wood or some other steel or anything you can take, and you can perform this activity and you yourself can witness it. Okay, so this is how the transfer of heat takes place, and the heat is very important factor because every object, it radiates heat or it transfers heat either to its surrounding or it takes the heat from its surroundings. So we will definitely go through it and we will understand that what are the different kinds of transfer of heat taking place in our environment or in our nature. Okay, so students, try performing this activity at home and try to write down your conclusion and let me know it in the WhatsApp group. Thank you.